Hello there, my name is Dr. Angelina Kakooza. I'm a neuropediatrician lecturer working in the Department of Pediatrics and Child Health at the School of Medicine, Makerere University, College of Health Sciences, Kampala, Uganda. I'm also the current president of the Uganda Epilepsy Society, a non-profit organization of professionals under the umbrella of the International League Against Epilepsy. The goal of our society is better control for epilepsy patients in Uganda, with a vision to have a country with controlled and well-managed epilepsy. I have been invited to speak at the first ever African Epilepsy Congress here in Nairobi on two topics. However, today I'm going to talk to you about epilepsy in the vulnerable groups, children and the elderly. Now, epilepsy is a common, chronic, and challenging physical illness, both for the child and for the parent. And in children, approximately 25% continue to experience poor seizure control, even with regular anti-epileptic drug therapy. Even when seizures are well controlled with anti-epileptic medications, epilepsy presents numerous potential clinical challenges that continue to expose these children to their vulnerability. Now, why are children with epilepsy vulnerable? This is due to disturbances in their brain that result from repeated seizures, adverse effects of the anti-epileptic medications, as well as focal brain abnormalities that are responsible for all problems that we see in these children. Learning disorders are found to be almost three times that seen in the normal population. Children with epilepsy are also plagued with low academic achievement, and this is contributed to by acquiring new skills or knowledge, challenges in focusing attention, difficulties with receptive and expressive speech, impaired motor and perceptual skills, and a compromised working memory. In addition, these children are prone to neuropsychiatric problems, and they include low self-esteem, lack of confidence, anxiety, depression, irritability, hyperactivity or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, aggression, and some get irrational periods of rage. These may be caused by a wide variety of issues, such as fear of the seizures, of their body being out of control during a seizure, being dependent on adults for care when their friends are becoming increasingly independent, especially for adolescents, fear of being hospitalized, coping with medication and possible side effects of these drugs, a lack of understanding from friends, and cases of bullying and teasing in some cases. Now, the psychiatric disorders identified in almost all these children, we find that they're almost five times the normal population. And the burden of having epilepsy makes them more psychologically vulnerable and less able to cope with the difficulties. Most often, these symptoms are under-recognized and under-treated. Now, regarding the social issues, parents have that overprotectiveness to these patients with epilepsy, restricting the child from various recreation activities, playing sports, and this actually isolates these children from important social learning experiences and further enhances a negative perception of self. This is compounded by the stigma associated with epilepsy and the insensitivity of others, also affecting the emotional and adaptive behavior responses in these children. Now, epilepsy is also a vulnerable condition in the elderly. Why is this? Epilepsy is the most common serious neurological disorder in the elderly after stroke and dementia, and the prevalence of epilepsy is highest amongst older adults, especially after the age of 65. The underlying factors identified in a greater proportion of elderly patients is things like cerebrovascular disease or stroke, dementia, and tumors. Epilepsy manifestation is somewhat different in the older individuals, so you find that oftentimes it is missed or misdiagnosed. It's also much more likely to have associated comorbid illnesses. Treatment of seizures is often complicated by concomitant medications and altered drug metabolism and excretion. And because polypharmacy is much more prevalent in the elderly, anti-epileptic drug therapy carries a greater risk of adverse effects and drug interactions, especially in elderly patients. Anti-epileptic drug use, especially also the older generation drugs, induces hepatic enzymes, which affect the excretion of these drugs as well as the bone health. There's decreased bone mineral density, so the risk of brittle bones and potential fractures is particularly relevant in the elderly. The elderly patient with epilepsy should be monitored for abnormalities in bone mineral density. Patients should also be advised to get adequate exposure to sunlight, a source of vitamin D, individualizing the choice of anticonvulsants to the characteristics of the patient, and avoiding anticonvulsants with important cognitive or sedative adverse effects, and where possible, treating with monotherapy. Appropriate adjustments of anti-epileptic drugs prescribing in the elderly include using a lower initial dose, slowly titrating, and then a lower target dose, much lower than that for the younger adults. There's also need to screen for school-age children for learning disabilities and comorbid neuropsychiatric conditions, and a need for collaborative approach between the school-based team, health professionals, parents, and the child to be able to understand and address the learning and social-emotional needs of the patient. Also, setting up a number of social-emotional supports in the child's environment is encouraged, and a climate of understanding and acceptance in the community is also recommended. So, what is our take-home message? Epilepsy is a complex neurological disorder that has an important impact on several aspects of the lives of vulnerable groups of children and the elderly. Seizure control should not just be the emphasis when we're managing these patients, but the specific issues that are peculiar to these groups of individuals should always be put into consideration. Thank you.